Namaste. Welcome to the series of Chair Yoga. My name is Sandeep Solanki. Today we are going to learn Pigeon Pose, called as Kaputasana. We are going to use chair as a prop for that. Few people, they cannot go into the posture because of inflexibility of the hip. Especially, a lot of time people come to either a downward facing dog to bring the leg forward, or sometimes they come to a cat pose or a tabletop pose to bring the leg forward to fix the leg so that they can get into the posture of this Kaputasana, the pigeon pose. But few people, those who are very stiff, they will find difficult to reach there, and then they will have to manipulate it. A lot of manipulation to come to the final position. And this is the reason why we are going to use this chair as a prop to get into the pigeon pose. This is a hip opening asana, and that's the reason why initially those who cannot practice at all, they can try using a chair to see whether it becomes easier for them or not. At the same time, the alignment of the body is also maintained. We don't want to go there and hold with misalignment of the body and bring strain on the other parts, the other joints. So we will use the chair as a prop for pigeon pose, the Kaputasana. For that, I will sit like this little cross, as if my navel button is facing on one side of the chair. Yeah? When we sit like this, make sure that your chairs will be different, so adjust accordingly. If you find that you have handle, the armrest, you can also sit a little behind. But this chair doesn't have the armrest, so I will sit in the center. Yes, of course I'm sitting a little behind, but I'm turned 45 degrees. Now I'm going to use my right leg and bring the right leg up like this. After bringing the right leg up, I will move the left leg behind, coming on the ball of the foot and the toes, lifting the heel up. And then I will keep both my palms on the side of the front leg, the upper leg, the right leg, like this. After this is achieved, I will arrange, adjust with the behind leg to bring it behind, and also to make sure that my both the hip line are squared. My front knee can be either little on the right side or aligned with the navel button, the right knee aligned little on the side or the navel button, and my behind leg is straight. Even if the knee goes a little down, that is fine, because I'm feeling a nice stretch right now at my hip joint. My spine is also straight. My chest is facing on that side, which is the right side. Both my hips are also squared at the right side. Just remain here. Those who are very stiff, the moment they come here, they will find a nice stretch in the right hip, in the right hamstring, in the groin region sometimes, the inner thigh region also, maybe in the lower back also of that particular side, the right side. Then maintain here. I can put my weight on the hand. I can just relax my hand and relax my shoulders. Chest is squared, hips are squared, and remain here. This brings an opening of the hip joint. Especially for those people who find that they reach in the posture and the other parts changes just to get into the posture. So make sure that you go into the posture, you reach in the fine position without compromising from other sides, the other parts. This is how you will also do with the other side. The purpose of using chair, especially on this asana, is to make sure that we gain flexibility of the hip joint, so that we can also do that on the floor, the proper pigeon pose. But initially, we can use chairs as a prop. Friends, if you like our videos, hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe. If you have any queries, questions, please feel free to write to us. We will revert it back to you. Keep tuned for watching more videos on this series of Chair Yoga. Thank you for watching. Namaste.